You know, everyone, everywhere can be a lifesaver. And our next guest is showing us how that can be very possible to save someone's life. He is with a company that is called Rapid Response Revival, and his name is Simon Shields. Simon, welcome into Tomorrow. How are you?
I'm really well, Dave. Thanks for inviting me.
It's a pleasure. Tell me first a little bit about the company, Rapid Response Revival.
Okay, we're a startup medical device company, and our founder, Don Casey's wife, had a cardiac arrest about 5 years ago. He needed to get then an AED to have around the house so that he was prepared if that was to happen again. And he really couldn't find one that he wanted. They're just too expensive, too bulky, complicated to use. And he set about with a colleague of his trying to work out how to make one that anyone anywhere could use.
So really, you're replacing those listening on the radio. Just come see the website, intotomorrow.com. You'll see the video. But you're replacing these kinds of big, bulky devices that you might find at airports and some businesses and that sort of thing with something much smaller, a little more than the size of a cell phone, I'm guessing.
That's right, and also much easier to use.
So show us the CellAED, and how does it work?
Okay, so this is a mock-up of the device. We're not allowed to have them out publicly yet because we're still going through certification. But to activate it, you snap it. There's no on or off button. Snapping it starts the process.
So almost like snapping a flare that you might be doing a nighttime light-up stick or something like that.
That's exactly right, yeah. So you snap it and then you peel. So you're peeling off the paper that's backing the pads. And so these pads have a strong gel on them, and you then go and place the pads on the chest and on the side of the patient. The pads are connected by a cable, and that is the entirety of the device. All the electronics, all the batteries, the capacitors, all the requirements to detect the heartbeat or lack thereof, they're in the device, and it then takes over. It will audibly respond and tell the user whether a shock is advised. It will then shock the patient, and at the same time, it delivers the GPS coordinates to emergency services.
Wow. I mean, it's all literally self-contained. I understand, though, it is a one-time use device, but if you can save my life one time, it's obviously paid for itself.
Well, the key is that it being available to be used when it's needed. At the moment, only between 3 and 10% of people in developed countries survive a cardiac arrest. But if there's a defibrillator around, it's more like 75 to 80% survival rate. Now, for every minute that a person does not have defibrillation and CPR, there's a 10% less chance of survival. So after 10 minutes, you're pretty well gone. Now, the typical ambulance takes longer than 10 minutes to get to a person. So that's why most people outside of a business situation or a common area like an airport don't make it.
Oh, for sure. Minutes, those first very few minutes count unbelievably. How soon will this be available?
Well, in the United States, probably about 3 years' time. We haven't gone to FDA approval yet. We're first working through the compliance for Europe, which is called CE mark.
And is there a price determined that it will likely be?
We're targeting $150 US.
Okay, and how would one carry this? Just throw it in a backpack, have it in a purse, put it in your glove box of the car, or what? It's very small compared to these other defibrillators.
That's right. Well, we have a case for it, which is not much bigger than the device, and that's the case that can be used in the home or the office. For people that want to carry it in a backpack or in a more extreme environment, we have an extreme environment case.
Got it. Rapid Response Revival. .com. It's a long URL, but we're going to get you there when you visit us at intotomorrow.com. Simon, keep up the good work. Very important. Saving lives. And if you guys can do that and get this out sooner than later, make sure to stay in touch and we'll let our audience know about it.
Thanks, Dave. Great to speak with you.
It's our pleasure again. RapidResponseRevival.com. Intotomorrow.com for more. We'll continue with more of our 25th year here in Las Vegas at CES. I'm Dave Graveline, bringing you Into Tomorrow on the Advanced Media Network.